Welcome back. The Kilted Piper here. Smoking my 7LE 614 Lucite stem. And this is that one, a little better close up on the stem this time. It has that pearl look to it. You see, you spin it around there. The browns and golds. Very beautiful stem. I love that stem. Enjoying some Ashton's artesian blend. Today I want to talk about something very specific. Beards. Many pipe smokers have beards. Some of you may have a white or silver beard, like myself. Let me ask you a question. Those of you with white or silver beards, difficult has it been for you to find beard oils and beard balms that don't turn your beard yellow, give it that brassy tinge to it? You know what I'm talking about. That faint yellow coloring in your beard gives it that dingy, dirty, bum look. Definitely not what we're going for here. I've tried a lot of different products, a lot of different beard oils, beard balms, made here in the US and other parts of the world. They all were good products, great at what they're meant to do. But unfortunately, they don't work on a white beard. Most of those products, because of what they're made with, are yellow. You open the can, it's yellow. That is going to turn your beard yellow as well. Why can nobody make a white beard balm? I've been searching, going broke, ordering all these different products, yet when I open them, they're all yellow. They all look the same. Most of them all smell the same too. Finally said enough's enough. I'm not going to rely on someone else with a black or brown beard to make my products for a white beard. Their products work great on their beards. Those dark colored beards, you can use any product out there. It won't harm your beard. Those of you with a white beard know we can't do that. We have to be very specific about what products we use. So I decided to start making my own. I have researched the ingredients. I've narrowed down where the problems are with the recipes. I have refined the recipes. In some cases, merely making higher quality choices on the ingredients. For instance, beeswax, one of the main ingredients in a balm. That's what gives your beard balm that holding power, is the beeswax. That simple yellow beeswax. You can get it at every craft store, order it online. Some of you may be lucky enough to have local beekeepers where you can get the beeswax from. That's one of the main culprits in turning the beard balm and hence your beard yellow, that yellow beeswax. The yellow beeswax is a less refined version of the beeswax. That's the beeswax that all these companies are using in their products. So I decided instead I'm going to use a higher quality beeswax. The beeswax that I am using is white. It's purified. The impurities in the wax that were turning it yellow have been filtered out. You still have the same wax, still have the same qualities of the wax, but you don't have the discoloration that's going to happen by using the other beard balms. I am currently working on two different recipes right now, two different types of beard balms. One is a more traditional beard balm, more holding power, get you through the day. I'm also working on a second type of beard balm. It's going to be more of a conditioning balm. I'm making this one more for nighttime use. We don't need a lot of hold in our beards when we're asleep. So this one, I'm adding more types of conditioning elements to the balm. Less wax. You don't need that hold. So as I work on these two different products, also testing them myself. I want to see what it's going to do to a white beard. I have one. I can see right in front of me what it's going to do to it. So as I make different refinements, testing them, making slight modifications, make another batch, test it again. Within the next couple weeks, I should be ready for some guinea pigs. No, just joking. I want to have other people try it. I want to get their feedback, what they think about it. Especially if you have a white beard. If you have a black, brown beard, red beard, any of the beard products out there you can use on your beard. It's only us with the white and silver beards that have to really be careful what we use on our beards. these products that I'm making, both the beard balm and beard oil that I'm making, are being made specifically for the white beard, white and silver beard. Now, that's not saying other people can't use it. As I said, if you have a darker beard, you can use any product. Even if it's made for a white beard, you can still use it. It's not going to harm your beard. But the other way around doesn't work. It's only the people that have the white and silver beards that are very specific about what products they use. This product is going to be good for them. This is going to be made with them specifically in mind. So over the next couple weeks, as I refine the beard oils and then the beard balms, I'm working on the oils first, and then I'm going to touch up the balms a little more. If you would like to be a tester for me, give me your feedback, let me know what you think of the product. Let me know. Also, what kind of scents would you like in an oil and a balm? Now, for the conditioning balm, the nighttime balm, pretty much set on that one with lavender and rosemary. Both of those are very relaxing scents. Since that balm is going to be meant for nighttime use, one with relaxing scents. Help you relax at the end of the day. Those scents wouldn't really be, in my opinion, that great for daytime use. So, trying out other scents. I just made up a batch of a Christmas scent that still refining that one a little bit. With some pines, some cinnamon, frankincense, myrrh. As I smell that one, all those memories of Christmas morning as a child started flooding back into my head. Let me know what you think. What would be your, if you could have a beard oil or a beard balm specifically made for you, what kind of scent would you have in yours? What kind of essential oil scents would you use if you were making it? We'll talk to you next time. Aloha from Hawaii.